Hello everyone, welcome to my second part in the shader tutorial series. Today we're going to take a look at accessing the depth buffer and using it to determine the distance between the water surface and what lies beneath the surface. We will then use that information to make the water seem darker the deeper it is. Accessing the depth texture works in the same way as accessing the screen texture. Shaders that access the depth buffer are rendered last in the queue, and the first shader that uses either the screen or depth texture triggers the copy being made. So anything rendered afterwards will not modify these textures. We start by temporarily disabling a few things in our shader. I'm clearing our emission output, and I'm setting the output of our height function to 0. I'm also disabling the normal map for now, and we set our roughness output to 1. We can now read the value from our depth texture. We use our unmodified screen UV here. To show what our depth value looks like, we simply output it as our albedo value. You'll notice our surface turns white. Our depth value is 0 close to the camera and goes up to 1 at our far plane. But this is a logarithmic scale. The values approach 1 fairly quickly. We'll need to scale up our value to just get our range to show. Please ignore my comment and code here. I have no idea what I intended to write, but ah well. Now we can see how our depth value quickly increases the further our surface is from the camera. As the water itself hasn't been rendered into the depth buffer, we can clearly see the shape of the pool's walls. There are several ways to convert the value in our depth buffer to the actual depth in view space. I've linked to a webpage in the description that provides more detail about this approach. We apply our usual x2-1 adjustment to get our value into a -1 to 1 range. Now we use a few values out of our projection matrix to reverse our projection calculation on our z value. Finally, we need to keep in mind that our object is about 10 units away from our camera, and the pool is 2 units deep, so we'll need to apply a scale to make this visible. Now we can see our depth more clearly, and as we zoom in and out, we can see how our pool becomes lighter the further away from the camera we are. We want to know the distance between the surface of the water and the pool wall behind it. Luckily, we have our view space position, and we can simply use vertex.z. Do note, z in view space is negative, while I've calculated our depth as a positive value. We thus add our z, not subtract it. As our pool is still 2 units deep, we still need to scale our value to make it visible. Now we can clearly see how the depth of our pool is encoded. Notice also that when I zoom in or out, the color doesn't change. The pool may be further away from the camera, the distance between water surface and the pool walls remains the same. Also note, when looking into the pool at an angle, we see a much brighter white because the distance we look through the water is much higher. Now, as light travels through a fluid medium, all sorts of funky things happen. The longer a light ray travels through a fluid, the more of this light is absorbed by the fluid, but how much is not linear, but exponential to the distance. This effect is called Beer's law, and I've put a link in the description with a more detailed explanation. We are thus going to use the exp function on our depth value. We do need to take the negative value. We can also see that our result is inversed as a result. The deeper the water, the darker our color. We'll apply a factor to our depth so that we have control over the murkiness of the water. The higher this factor, the darker the color. The more light will absorb, the murkier the water. Let's turn this factor into a uniform so we can control it from outside of our shader. Absorbing the light traveling through our water is directly proportionate to the transparency of our water, and we can thus simulate this by using the value we just calculated as the alpha of our shader. Let's move a few things around in preparation of this. Note that I'm placing part of the refraction code higher up in the shader, which in hindsight was not needed, but doesn't hurt. Now we copy the depth calculation we just prepared into the spot where we're calculating our alpha value. Next, we remove our temporary code for visualizing our depth. And finally, we use the inverse of the output of our exponential function as our alpha. We do clamp the value between 0 and 1 to prevent artifacts. You can really see that where we're looking through deeper water, the water becomes far less transparent. Do note that our factor of 2 makes for very dirty water. Also, our cartoonish water texture ruins the effect a tiny bit, as it is far too bright to color. let's play with the beer factor value a bit and see what it does. As you can see, the lower this value, the clearer the water becomes. Let's undo some of the changes we made to disable the water animation. I also think the roughness is applied too strongly to the refraction, so let's tweak that a little. This really should be a uniform you can set. I've tweaked a few more settings, changing the color of our texture and such to improve the effect. You can look at the final version of the source code on my GitHub page. The link is in the description below. I hope you learned something from this video. I would greatly appreciate a like if you did. I'm going to do more with the def buffer in a future video, so if you don't want to miss that, consider subscribing to this channel and hit the bell notification button. Also, please check out the playlist for this series, which also includes GD Quest's amazing videos that showcase 2D shaders in Godot and dive deeper into some of the basics of writing shaders. Thank you for watching. Until next time!